feeling like walk a flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game in my pocket, but I won't again.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run shotgun.
Get ready for an AFC East rivalry where Buffalo looks for their third straight over New York. It's the Bills and the Jets, and Week 10 is coming at you on EA Sports.
From the stadium that hosted Super Bowl 48 back in 2014, there's a look at MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford. A few moments ago, the crowd here was on their feet as their beloved Jets made their way out of the tunnel. They're ready to go. It should be a good one as the New York Jets get set to face off with the Buffalo Bills. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis and CD. You look at the Jets coming into play. They know coming in they've got to be at their best because they're facing one of the better overall defenses in the NFL.
And this is not one of the better offenses around in terms of running the football. So they understand that they're going to be put to the test a bit. The big plays in the run game, they haven't been there of late, so maybe that means we'll see them shake things up a little bit. Some RPOs, some touch passes, some draw plays, anything to try and gain a little bit of momentum.
They go play action here on first down. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time to have a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
So, Charles, take nothing away from this young man under center, because I know people think he's got a very bright future in this league, but I have to figure the defensive coordinators love the thought of squaring off against a rookie quarterback.
And especially if they have guys they can put together a game plan with that's going to confuse, disguise a lot of coverage, make this kid think a little bit. Because in college, he's seen a lot of things. Let's not get it wrong here. But at the same time, in the NFL, you can do so much more because of the athletes you have, because of their football IQ. And don't forget, you're going to throw a couple extra rushers at him as well and see if he can handle the pressure when those guys come at him.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. Give him six on the screen, but now it's third down. Back to throw. Dodson. And that is incomplete. Now a play fake here on first down. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Off the edge, Mario Addison gets the sack. Off the play fake, Dodson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. And this pass broke.
Hey,
Off play action. Dodson. He's going to find his tight end. That's Chris Herndon. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. It's a big play that time by the Jets. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. He'll air this one out deep for Davis. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And the Bears are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's going to go down as a loss of 9 on the first down play. Back quite a ways here, facing second and 19. From the gun, Dodson going deep here for Landry. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Uncorks one for Davis. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And they finally put an end to this return, but not before he's all the way down to the 30. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. That's pulled in, the veteran Carter Landry. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Throwing on first down. Dodson. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a two-score game at half that makes it feel like much less. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he is going to score. It's a pick six and a Bills touchdown. Throwing after the interception. Dodson rolling to his left. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set. Off the play fake. Dodson. He will find the rookie from Ole Miss, Elijah Moore.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
He'll check it down to Bell. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Back-to-back 11-yard gains, and they've got another first down. Looking to throw. Dodson, and he completes it to Berrios, and he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Off play action, Dodson, escaping the pressure right. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Off the play fake. Dodson. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. He was trying to find his tight end. On first down, Dodson. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Back to throw. Dodson got his man. It's the veteran Landry. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Off the bootleg, Dodson. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass.
That's going to be caught by Crowder. It's a Jets touchdown. Jamison Crowder, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jets are able to close the gap just a bit. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. On first and 10, Dodson. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
And he'll get this underneath to Bell.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Back now here on EA Sports. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. Throwing on first down. Dodson will return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 49-yard line. He's going to look deep now for Landry. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. On first down, Dodson. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Now they got to get to the line quickly. To throw on second down, Dodson. And he's got the hook up to Landry. Gets through and now an opening. And he is finally out of bounds across midfield at the 40-yard line. Big yardage that time for the Jets. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. And bringing it in, it's Davis. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he... Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do...
Well, if you're a Jets fan these days, it is hard not to feel disappointed. Your beloved team's been eliminated from the postseason, and there's nothing to do but play for pride at this point. And the reality is, it's been more than a decade now since gangrene made its last playoff appearance, that second consecutive AFC Championship game. That's a new generation of fans who've never seen a Jets playoff game. But enough of that. Let's shift our focus now to the team's...
Here's the first carry for Le'Veon Bell. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 48-yard line. Eluding the pressure right. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. But Charles, in the past, a lot of people called this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense, and now as a defensive coordinator, you've got some extra work to do.
And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. It's a loss of a yard, so they wind up crediting him with a sack, and it brings up third down. From the gun on third down, Dodson. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Raekwon Davis. On first and 10, Dodson forced out to his left. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
And the Dolphins rush gets home, down he goes. Call it a loss of 5, a big sack to bring up third down. Throwing on third and long. Dodson flushed out right. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 3-3, a tight one after one on EA Sports. Throwing on first down. Dodson. Crowder's got it over the middle. And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
This was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
20! And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A big pick up there on the scramble.
I think the last two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy, because you know he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for them.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm really of how he can hurt you. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Looking to throw. Dodson. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Christian Wilkins showing his strength and quickness there. A loss of 4. On third down, Dodson. Under pressure, and they got to him again. First down, Dodson. He'll get this one complete to Davis. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
I know you're trying not to scoreboard, Rosh, but you only got 3 points. You're kind of hoping that type of play there gives you some positive momentum going into the half.
They need to do something to get more than that 3 number that they have on the scoreboard right now. On first and 10, Dodson. This is Bell on the dump off. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Second and 1. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Dolphins have got it. Throwing on first down. Dodson. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. First down now, but that clock rolling. Back to throw. Dodson. And that's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
A screen to Bell. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. They'll look to throw again.
Time to give a little credit here.
He's got a man complete. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. And he's got his man on the crossing route. That's Landry. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. Here's second and goal. Back to throw again. Now he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Coleman, and the Dolphins. On first down, Dodson. Caught here by Bell. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Well, you don't expect too many quarterbacks to be adept at breaking away from would-be tacklers, but this is uncommonly good right here as he's able to get away. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Now this one complete downfield on the left side and inside the 20 before he's brought down. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They looked like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. And now they're in the hurry up. Looking to throw on second down. Dodson. They juked him. And that is caught. It's Davis. And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the two. Bell. Fighting his way in for a Jets touchdown. Le'Veon Bell with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Jets are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there.
On first and 10, Dodson. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Escaping the pressure right. He'll have a first down past the 40. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. It's a big play that time by the Jets. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. On the move to his left. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out.
Containing him is
We've already seen this once earlier in this drive.
Yeah, and so now two times this has happened. Do you adjust something?
Yeah, I think you do. I think you got to start thinking about your rush lanes. Try not to either get too wide or too narrow. Make sure someone is there waiting for him to take off.
And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Bernard McKinney, the former Texan, there to make the stop. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Flush to his right. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
And showcasing those strong legs on that run, getting through one tackle. Now she winds up getting eight there. Bell once more. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Le'Veon. Throwing on first down. Dodson, the loop, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jalen Phillips in there to drop him, and that will go in the books as the first sack of his young NFL career. Congratulations, young man.
Boy, that's tough, Charles. First play of the drive, you're hoping to stay ahead of schedule. You take that huge sack, and now you're facing second and a mile.
And the entire time, you were probably thinking the same thing I was. Either get rid of the ball, safely, of course, or go down. The yardage he gave up on that play, that's going to be...
And this is going to be intercepted. Brandon Jones picking it off. And the Dolphins will have solid field position here. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That's caught left side by Landry. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
And part of a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars. And he came through with a nice catch right there.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go. And this is going to be intercepted. Nick Needham picks it off. And his guys are going to take over. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2. And it's a rush to the line right now for the Jets. He'll look to throw. Flushed out right. He'll have a first down past the 40 and all the way up to the 45-yard line. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw. It's caught by Davis. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Very much in range for a tying field goal as they hurry to the line. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. And with 4 seconds remaining, they will call the timeout. So just... They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. Bell sheds him off, and he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. On first down, Dodson escaping the pressure right. Puts it on the carpet, it's out. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down.
The give is to Bell. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
48 yards rushing for him now as he was just trying to will his guys to an overtime victory.
Now after the run by Bell, here's another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. And that carry, probably not so much for yardage, just to get the spot that you want to get the field goal.
And in a yardage game, there's really kind of gravy, and this just becomes what my old coach used to say, get into position to be in position. And that's what they want, the right spot for their kicker to line up the field goal.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Looking to throw, Dodson. Oh, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Eric Rowe. And the Dolphins are going to have it. On first and 10, Dodson being chased out left. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On second down, it's Bell, and this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, third and 1. They'll go again with Bell. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Throwing on first down, Dodson flush to his right. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Out of the shotgun, it's Bell. And he'll get about 4 as he's brought down at the 24. And it's a rush to the line right now for the Jets. To throw on second down, Dodson eluding the pressure right. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags. In overtime. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So for the Jets, it's a win they needed, if for nothing else in their sanity, as they move to 4-6. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Houston Texans. Meanwhile, for Miami, their luck may have run out as they fall to 4-7 now in the year. And they'll be back home next week as they're set to take on the Carolina Panthers.